Una says, listen, Elise, whatever happens, don't be surprised. Yeah. Surprised by what? You'll find the answer soon, says Forte. By that. It's begun, says McBain. Miss Marito says, what's going on? Mayo Halstow saying, what the hell? Heavens, it's a pirate ship. Wow, says Eton, it's so cool. What are you talking about? Miss Ripthea says. Guerrero says, everyone please calm down. McBain says, they're just threatening us so those cannonballs won't hit the ship. Elise says, the pirate we saw the other day. Oh, they're just, like, warning shots? Yeah, they're supposed to just scare us. Something tells me they're gonna do more than that, though. Cease fire, says Ramon. Green-haired pirates. It's made of seaweed. Damn, the mast. Got seaweed hair. Rian says they're trying to get aboard our ship. He's very intuitive. Eton says the pitch black dragon with skull and crossbones. The flag. It's Pirate King Ramon's black dragon. Yeah, no kidding, buddy. Ramon says, shut up. I am Pirate King Ramon. Unfortunately, you're in my territory. Say your prayers. Here's Merchant Rish. Please wait. Please. Please hear me out. Who are you? Says Ramon. My name is Rish. I am the owner of this ship, the Banquet. Oh, I know your name. You're the infamous, unscrupulous merchant. So what do you want to tell me? I am responsible for the safety of my guests. If what you want is money, I may be able to help you. Please, do not harm anyone. Ho ho, I like you, unscrupulous merchant. Alright, why don't you come here, alone? What? Me alone? Oh yeah, this is how they get away. McBain says, what a monkey show. Ambassador Bureger says, I can't make Rish a scapegoat. Ramon, take me too. Who are you? I am Bureger from the Numeros Empire. I'll negotiate on behalf of the guests. Huh. Alright then. But don't ever think about tricking me. If you make even one funny move, that's it. You understand? You too. Come here. I just let this happen. I was wrong about Rish, says Mayor DeMille. I may have misunderstood him. He is a brave man. Not really. Miss Marito says Ambassador Bureger is also a noble soul. Because of the way he looks, I thought he was a bad guy. Yo, he is a bad guy. McBain says, Elise. Yes. Probably the pirates will invade our ship soon. You help Ambassador Guerrero to guide the guests to the stern. Understood. How about you? We'll pull a Captain Thomas act or something. Really? Oh yeah, what's his name? Supposed to take care of this guy. The dummy steersman chuckling. Things are going smoothly. Not for long. Slade says, excuse me. What do you want? Is it difficult to steer a side wheel steamer? Not at all. It's easy. We don't have to worry about wind. Then we don't need the steersman. What? Have a good rest. I guess he knocked him out. I was wondering if he killed him. But I don't think so. Pirate Ryan says, hee-haw, I'm the first one in. Hee-haw. He's the one on the YouTube comments going first. Listen up, people. Boss told us not to hurt you, but I'll do things my own way. You can do whatever you want, too. The pirates roar. Forte says, I won't let you lay even a finger on the guests on this ship. Haha, what can't you do, you pest? What did you say, says McBain? We're gonna fight those four? What about the backup? A vulgar sailor says, here I come too. Miss Rapthea says, wait. I won't run away from you pirates. Come on. Huh. You're bossy. Have we met before? Yeah. In Muth. You really trashed me there with your bad mouth. He's a vulgar sailor. He's talking about bad mouth. Do you want to hear them again? Says Miss Rapthea. You fool. You regret you said that. It was just a question. Slade says, you're disgraceful. Getting so worked up against a woman. What? Alright, that's actually not too cool. They can get worked up, and she can kick their butt any day of the week. Slade says, excuse me. Of course, Rapthea says. What are you doing? Says the sailor. Slade kicked the gangway hard. Whee! Oh, I thought he was gonna fall in the water. Hey, take it easy. I'm on the gangway. Not anymore, you're not. Are you alright, brave woman? Says Slade. Thank you. I'm fine. That's good. I'll defend here, so you stay with the others. Yes, she says, blushing. McBain says, I thought you had more muscles. That stupid guy, says Ryan. Grandpa, we should get going. Going where? Going to kick their butts? Pirate encountered. Alright, we got these meters. Who has the sleep? Ah, yeah. Okay, let's put Pirate D to sleep. I don't remember which button we press. Actually, they have a... Yeah, we're all full. Not that button. Forte? Sheep of time? Nope, that's not the button. Yeah, I wish I could remember. Alright, let's... Let's put us. Let's put B. Okay, so we'll have B and D sleeping. Like I said, they'll do the paro-paro cure. Lick, lick. Oh, I forgot. That time I forgot to try. Trying to get these attacks, but I don't remember what key to press. How do we do that? Alright, stand by, guys. I'm just gonna stop for a second and look this up. Okay, looked that up, and now I remember. We're supposed to attack, use the special attack when the enemy is about to attack. And we press, well, it's the square button. But I have a Logitech controller, so for me it's the one button. So Pirate C is the only one still awake. Let's see if we can do it. Oh, we might just kill him. I don't think he can attack. Alright, and we move this like that. Don't attack the sleeping one. Ah, you woke them both up. Nice going, Egghead. Pirate D, go back to sleep. Pirate B. She didn't do it. Maybe it's not the square. Oh wait, she's using it now. Forte leveling up. Fit level 15. Jan and Rick. McBain. And Una, all level 15. Wonder if they have any new attacks and stuff. Slade says, have you cleaned up yours? Well, just look at him. You can see him, right? It's our turn, says Forte. We must go and rescue Roland. I'll come with you. Slade, join the company. Okay. McBain says, let's get on the Black Dragon. You try to talk to them. You're some fighters, Pirate says. Damn you, says Pirate Ryan. Like Private Ryan, we've been defeated. Alright, before we get on there, let's... we can talk to some other people. Gareno says, all others have evacuated to the stern. Don't worry about us and fight as much as you want. I don't know. How much do we want to fight? So there's no one down here then. McBain says, we have no time going down to the ship's hold. We must rescue Roland as soon as possible. All guests are accounted for. Please bowl the pirates down. The pirates are invading us, and the two are still fighting. They must get on really great. Sarcasm? Trying to steal the ship. The impervious mayor says that cannons are the best weapons to get rid of the pirates. Does he know how much it costs to purchase a cannon? Well, she spelled cannon wrong. Mayor DeMille says the lady president says that hand-to-hand battle is the best strategy to fight against the pirates. But it will result in many casualties. I think cannons are better. Well, I don't know if we have cannons. If I knew, I should have eaten that scallop mousse as much as I could. Still talking about the food. Don't do anything reckless. You must travel around the world and entertain people. Oh sure, fighting a ship full of pirates, you're not reckless at all. Eton says, wow, look at the many gun ports. It's much better armed than regular warships. Slade is brave, sure-footed, and gallant. I've never met anybody like him before. Alright. Let's just save again. Wish it was easier to sort through these. McBain says, how about a piece of music? What? Says Ramon, don't mess with me. It was quite a performance, but the ending must change. Rich says, you. I guess you know everything. Bureger says, if that's the case, you can't leave here alive. I'll have to silence you here. I agree, says Ramon. Reputation is everything in our trade. Please take care of them, you two, says Rish. Leave them to us, says Ramon. You sit there and watch. Slade says, let's see how good the Pirate King is. Oh, I forgot to look at their... what happened when they level up, like if we got new skills and stuff. Have we met somewhere before? Maybe, says Slade. You can check yourself with your sword. Check with the sword. This is Ambassador Bureger of Merchant Rish encounter. Alright, what do we have? Anything new? I don't see any new spells for him. I mean, yeah, spells. And then what about skills? I don't see anything new there either. Alright. Pirate A, B... So we should save the special moves for the... I think I put the Pirate A and B to sleep and just focus on the other two. Yeah, that's a good idea. Sheepy time. About Ramon. Oh, I forgot to look. I'm forgetting. Grandel? Is that new? A spell cast by the Phrase of Earth drops a huge rock to damage all enemies. Yeah, that'll probably mess up his sleep thing if he casts it before her, so... Aim well, care, and aim far. Okay. I don't see anything new there. Ice rain? That's new. A spell cast by the Phrase of Water. Icicles rain from the sky to damage all enemies. Oops. Didn't mean to do that. Oh, he missed? Wow. I'd be hitting the dog. Hey! I said don't hit the dog. Oh, they're really focusing on him. Adagio? On the dog, I guess? He slowed him. That poor thing. Alright. Leave our dog alone. Una goes last, right? I think. Heal. Aww. I'm trying to get this thing going here. There we go. Jump rush. Wow, that pirate's still kicking, huh? Alright, so... I believe we need an item for this. Leash bottle? That's for magic. Yeah, bear with me, I don't remember which thing revives. Restore snuff? Well, I have six of those. Actually, let's heal McBain. McBain will continue attacking Ramon. Load him. Rock! Crash! Hopefully this one pirate will be out of the battle now. Nice. Oh boy, you better heal him good. Sweet. It said moderate amount. I was afraid it wouldn't be enough. Okay. Much as I hate to ignore the two big guys, we need to get some of these numbers down, and these regular pirates are going to be easier for that. Then they'll be outnumbered by us, these two. Oh, Jan and Rick are full now. I'll have McBain continue with Ramon. Charge, dog! That's why we revived him. Wow, 1,004? That's crazy. Oh, need some healing. We'll continue on B. Paro cure on Forte. And McBain still attacking Ramon. Nice, okay, we just got these two enough now. Missed. Minimal damage. Alright, everyone can attack Ramon now. Ramon is down. You're doomed, Rish. I mean, Bureger. That's right. Rish isn't attacking. Let's do a little cure on McBain. Because we might be in another battle directly after this. Maybe with Rish. And other pirates. I'm not going to use our special attack. I want to save it. I missed a charge dog. That was awesome. Slow this. Wow. Slade says, bring Roland here. Or, do you still want to fight? Says McBain. Rish says, oh, no, no. I'll bring him right away. He's like jumping, hopping around. Roland, says Forte. Haha, I'm sorry. We're glad you're fine, says McBain. Alright, let's get back to the banquet. What's taking them so long, Gareno says. Roland yelling, Elise! Elise is like, hmm? I hear Roland's voice. How come? Because his mouth is speaking his voice. Move the ship! Roland yells. Move it where? Evasive maneuvers! Yes, sir, she says. The banquet is going evasive. Rish says, my banquet. Ramon says, ouch. Hey! I don't want to fight you again. Damn, I'm not going to let you go. Get up! Blow up the outer wheels of the banquet. That's not fair. We fought him fair and square. He should not be getting up and have people blow up wheels of the banquet. Don't let it get away. Aye, aye, sir. You stupid. What are you aiming at? Says Ramon. But we haven't fired yet, sir. That means... Are we being hit? Look, that ship, says Rish. Ramon is swallowing his breath. It's Is this the backup? Looks like there was something under the water. It's the Planetos 2! That white ship, that's the Planetos 2 of Captain Thomas. My God, says Rish. Ramon, do something. It's too late. They've preempted us. We have no choice but to flee. They preempted you. Una says, the pirate ship is running away. That sailboat, says Forte, is that our backup Slade had mentioned earlier? Thank God it got here in time, Slade says. I didn't know we had this ship in Burrowdane, says Garino. By the way, where are Elise and Roland? Forte asks. We should leave them alone. They are in there. She's moving, he's not. Ethan says, wow. I'm so impressed. Well, you got to go on all the ships you wanted, maybe. Garino says, what a surprise. The ship was the Planetos too. But how did it happen? Slade says, the captain is a personal friend of mine, that's all. He's really cool, says Forte. Garino says, you and your friends have been helping us a lot, McBain. Without your superb performance, all of us would have been taken hostage by now. You should thank Slade instead of us, says Forte. He's right, McBain says. Slade is organized and swift. He has been a tremendous help. I didn't do much, he says. By the way, would you like to travel on the Planetos too? I'll borrow this ship and get back to Polka, then back to my home country. If you're planning to go to Marcheros, I'll take you to Polka with me on this ship. That's not a bad idea, says McBain. By the way, Grandpa, we didn't get our winning prize at the audition from Rish. Forget about it, says Una. I don't want to see his face ever again. You're right, says Forte. All right, McBain says. We'll go to Polka, too. We should move on. Yeah, we shouldn't decline Slade's offer, says Forte. Okay, then, Slade says. Forte, Una, says Roland. And McBain, Slade, I can't thank you enough for rescuing me. Elise says, I won't forget this for the rest of my life. Elise, says McBain. Your father gained the respect of Pirate King Ramon and forced Rish to pay the money to relocate the villagers. He was a great village chief. Thank you. I'm proud of my father, too. I feel a little strange, though. I had so much concern about the island, but today's incident just... How shall I pull it? Put it. Cleared up my mind. I can now take positive steps in my life. I really feel that way. I'm making a fresh start, together with my greatest love... Elise, says Roland. Yes, that's her name. The two blushed. Subleader Ruka. Oh, Ruka? Says, well, everyone, I'm sorry to interrupt. Don't we know Ruka? The wind is changing direction, and we must leave. Oh, then I want to have a word with the captain. I want to thank him personally. Since he's not coming out, he may not be here, says Slade. Ruka says the captain is not in right now. I see, McBain says. Then please send our best regards to him. Yes, I will. We'll go first. So long. Open mast number one. Elise says, please take care, all of you. I hope to see you again. Roland says, when we meet again, I'll cook lots of delicious food until you can't eat anymore. I look forward to it, says Forte. Good luck, Una says. McBain says, Ambassador Garino, please send our regards to others. Of course. So long, everyone. Bon voyage, instead of bon voyage. Is that the German version? Bon voyage? Goodbye, says Forte. Slade says, well... We should get going, too. Hey, Grandpa. The resonance stone on Riotam Island is called Bind. Yes, so? Elise is now freed from her past that was binding her to Riotam Island. Right. You've gained insightful eyes, Forte. The evil plot of Merchant Rish and Ambassador Bureger was foiled by the McBain Company with the help of Garino and Slade. The appearance of the Pirate King Ramon created a commotion which no one anticipated. In spite of the difficult situation, Roland was rescued successfully. Forte thought that the series of events told him the story of binding, how people who were bound to the island in many ways. Under the skillful steering of Slade, the Banquet left Perpolka in March arose. The outer wheels rolling elegantly on both sides of the ship left a white trace on the beautiful sea. Chapter 2, Pirates March, The End. Polka. No, that is not Polka. Thank you, Mr. Slade, says Forte. No problem, says Slade. Una says, we were saved because Mr. Slade knew how to steer the ship. McBain says, thank you for everything. Una says, Mr. Slade, what are you going to do next? I'll borrow this ship and go to some port to find people from my country. Forte says, if we have a chance to go to Bureger during our tour, we'll visit you for sure. Yeah, Slade says, sounds good. I'm looking forward to that. Why is he stuttering? Take care, says McBain. Bye, all. You take care, too. Chapter 3, Hermit's Serenade.